In this problem, we will calculate the entropy change at constant temperature when two gases are mixed at constant pressure. And so it's 1 mole of nitrogen and 2 moles of oxygen. Assuming they're ideal gases, solution could be done a couple ways. One way is to look at what the situation is. We could visualize. We have a container. Since we have twice as much oxygen as nitrogen, it means the volume of oxygen is twice the volume of nitrogen. So this is at 1 bar, and this is 1 mole. This is also at 1 bar, and it's 2 moles. And essentially, we're visualizing, we're doing the mixing, where now we have oxygen plus nitrogen, and it's at 1 bar, and it's a total of 3 moles. Since these are ideal gases, one way to visualize what's happening is to imagine that the nitrogen is expanding into vacuum, and that the oxygen is expanding into vacuum. So we will move the partition, if you like, and now we have nitrogen at lower pressure. If this is 1 bar and the total volume is 3 times the nitrogen volume, then this would be 1/3 bar. And when the oxygen expands, again starting at 1 bar into this same volume, it would be pressure of 2/3 bar. And essentially the entropy change results because of the reduced partial pressure of oxygen nitrogen. Important thing to keep in mind, ideal gases, which means no interaction between the molecules. So we're going to do the entropy change by looking at the partial pressure changes or looking at the volume changes. So we're going to separately calculate the entropy change for nitrogen and the entropy change for oxygen. So this entropy change is minus the number of moles of nitrogen times the gas constant times the log of the final pressure over the initial pressure. Now, these are just the pressures for nitrogen. Right, so this is minus 1 mole, gas constant, and let's keep the units in the calculation, gas constant R, and the log, final pressure 1/3, initial pressure 1, so log of 1/3. So this is equal to 1.10 mole times R. And if we substitute in for R in SI unit, 8.314 joules per mole per Kelvin. Right? So R, 8.314 joules, mole, and Kelvin. Well, the same calculation for the entropy change for oxygen, so 2 moles times R, log of the final pressure 2/3, the initial pressure is 1, so log of 2/3, and this equals 0.81 moles times R. So the total entropy change for mixing is just the sum of the nitrogen entropy change plus the oxygen entropy change, which is 1.10 R plus 0.81 R, which is 1.91 R, which 16 joules per Kelvin. So that's the entropy change for mixing of these two gases, constant pressure, constant temperature. Check our answer. It's positive entropy change, as we would expect, because this is an irreversible process when we mix these together. The other way to do the calculation is to use the equation expressed in terms of the mole fractions. So this is the mole fraction in the final mixture. And so delta S of mixing for this case would be -3, total number of moles. And then X1 or X nitrogen, log of X nitrogen plus X oxygen, log of X oxygen, which is -3 times 1/3 the log of 1/3 plus 2/3 log of 2/3, which becomes minus the log of 1/3 minus 2 times the log of 2/3. And this, of course, is the same numbers as I got above, so we're going to get the same value, 1.91 R, for the entropy change, or in two significant figures, SI units, 16 joules per Kelvin.